Hello student, welcome to one more session of AARM. This is Vasan Naik from Canada Engineering College. In this session, we will see the arithmetic instructions. That is the processing instruction we use most of the time in the programs. Arithmetic and logical instructions. In this session, you will see first arithmetic instructions. So now, let me write here arithmetic instructions like add, subtract, etc. So let me write first here, first instruction is nothing but add R0, R1, R2. Dear student, as I told in my previous video, ARM support triadic instruction. Triadic instruction means you can use three operands. In this example, you can see here, we have used R0, R1 and R2, three operands. That doesn't mean that we are going to add R0 plus R1 plus R2. No, it is not like that. It is here, the meaning is R0 will get the data from the addition of R1 plus R2. Here R0 is the destination which will get the data from the addition of R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2. Let me write here. Yeah. So R0 is nothing but R1 plus R2. The second instruction. Now we will move to the second instruction. Second instruction is ADC, add with carry. Add with carry R0. R1, R2 means R0 will get the data from the addition of R1 plus R2 plus carry flag. Carry from the previous stage. This is nothing but carry from the previous stage. Let me explain you with the small example. Suppose I want to add two numbers. That is, I want to add 12 FF with 0001. Let me add this one. When you add this one, you will get here 0, 0, and this becomes one is the carrier and this becomes 13. Suppose I want to do this addition in two stage. That is, first I want to add two. Like first I want to add 8-bit numbers, then I want 8-bit addition, next I want to do higher 8-bit addition. First I want to do lower 8-bit addition, then I want to do higher 8-bit addition. In that case, think like that. I am taking small example here. So here, when I want to add lower 8-bit numbers, then I will use add instruction, add S instruction, add S. You know what is the use of S? S will change the status flag based on the addition. So, when you add this number, there will be a carry. So, carry flag becomes 1. And when you add the higher 8-bit numbers, that time you will use here add with carry. So, what it will do? It will add 12 plus 1. 1 from carry flag. 1. That becomes 13. So, when you want to add bigger, very big number, so the lower order of the number, for to add the lower order of the number, we use normal add S. After that, each higher order of the number, we use ADC. That means what it will do is, it will add the carry from the previous stage. So that is the meaning of that one. So next. Third one is subtract. Subtract R0, R1, R2. It will subtract R2 from R1. So R0 is nothing but R1 minus R2. So R2 is subtracted from R1 and result is stored in R0. Fourth one is subtract with carry, SBC, subtract with carry, that time R0, R1, R2. Here R0 is nothing but R1 minus R2 minus inverted carry flag. So now student, here you need to understand something. So when we subtract, for example, let me subtract 9 from 7, that time there will be borrow. So in case of ARM, if there is a borrow, carry flag becomes 0. If there is no borrow, carry flag becomes 1. If there is a borrow, carry flag becomes 0. If there is no borrow, carry flag becomes 1. So let me explain you this with the example. So I want to subtract, for simplification, I use decimal number. I want to subtract 9 from 47. So anyway, 7 is smaller than 9. So it will take, I will take a borrow from 4. So 17 minus 9, that time this becomes 8. And here, when there is a borrow, what we will do is, we will subtract 1 from 4, that becomes 3. So same thing is followed here. You see, R0 is nothing but R1 minus R2 and carry flag, inverted carry flag. Why? Because there is a borrow, that time carry flag becomes 0. So if you subtracted 0, that is a meaningless. That's why what we do is inverted borrow, that is inversion of carry flag is used, that time it will subtract 1. So R1 minus R2 minus 1. R1 minus R2 minus 1. So that is the meaning of SBC. Similarly, we have one more instruction, student. One more instruction is RSB. Reverse subtraction, RSB, R0, R1, R2. Normal subtraction, R2 is subtracted from R1. In the reverse subtraction, R0 is nothing but R2 minus R1. R1 is subtracted from R2. In the reverse subtraction, R1 is subtracted from R2. Like that, we have one more instruction here. RSC, reverse subtraction with carry. So RSC, R0, R1, R2. Here R0 is nothing but R2 minus R1 minus inverted carry flag, inverted borrow, inverted carry flag. So R0 is nothing but R2 minus R1 minus inverted carry flag, as I explained earlier. So this is arithmetic instruction. So now, student, we'll take one instruction, that is, for example, R S C E Q S R1, R2, R3. What is the meaning of this one? See, when this type of instruction comes, it looks like complicated, but you see the core of the instruction. Core of the instruction is, for example, core of the instruction is reverse subtraction. So reverse subtraction, that is R3 is subtracted from R2 is subtracted from R3 with carry. So here with carry only when previous instruction, the previous operation, like previous operation results in equal, then after doing this operation, it will update the status flag register. So here it is something like R1 is equal to R3 minus R2 minus carry flag inverted. So in the exam, you will get 10 mark question, like 5 to 6 question for 10 marks. So it's very easy to attend those questions, because you have to first understand the instruction step by step. So now we will proceed to next level of instruction, that is multiply instruction. So in multiply instruction, we have 32-bit multiplication and 64-bit multiplication. Now if you ask me what is the difference between 32-bit multiplication, 32-bit multiplication results in 32-bit result. 64-bit multiplication, long multiplication, 32-bit multiplication results in 64-bit multiplication. Some 32-bit multiplication results in 32-bit result, but some 32-bit multiplication results in 64-bit result. For example, if I take, if you take 8-bit number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you take two highest 8-bit number 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then if you multiply this number, this results in 16-bit. But if you take a smaller number like 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, and if you multiply this one 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, then this results in the 8-bit. Similarly, 32-bit, when you multiply, as a programmer, you know whether the result will be a 32-bit or 64-bit. So normal multiplication results in 32-bit and long multiplication results in the 64-bit. So that is the one thing you need to understand here. So now we'll proceed. Here, you see, mul R0, R1, R2. Mul is used for multiplication. So R0 will get the result of multiplication of R1 and R2. We have one more instruction, multiply and accumulate. When you multiply very long number, normally we multiply, when you multiply very long number, each time you will get partial product. That partial product will be accumulated finally to get accumulated at this stage to get the final answer. So multiply, and that's why the name multiply and accumulate. So here you see R0 will get the value of multiplication of R1 and R2, which is accumulated to the register R3. Same instruction I will write in the other way. MLA R0, R1, R2, R0. What is the meaning of this one? R0 will get the value of multiply of R1 and R2. It will be accumulated to the register R0, and finally it will be stored in R0. So initially R0 will initialize to 0, and whatever multiplication value, whatever the result we will get from the multiplication, that will be accumulated in this R0 register. And as the loop continues, this register will get accumulated with the multiplied value of each time. So that is multiply and accumulate. Similarly, long multiply. Long multiply, we use instruction UMULL. So here, U indicate unsigned, MUL indicate multiplication, and L indicate long multiplication. So here, you multiply R2 and R3, two 32-bit number, result is 64, and 64-bit number is stored in two register of 32-bit, R1 and R0, where R0 will get lower order and R1 will get higher order. Similarly, SMUL is used for signed multiplication. So signed multiplication also, only the difference between this is for unsigned and this is for signed multiplication, it will follow signed multiplication process. Now similarly, we have unsigned multiply and accumulate, signed multiply and accumulate. So here you multiply R2 and R3. The result of that will be accumulated in R1 and R0, and final result is stored in R1 and R0. When you multiply each time R2 and R3, that will be accumulated to R1 and R0. R1 and R0. And finally it is stored in R1 and R0. Similarly, we have something called as SMLAL. SMLAL means signed multiply and accumulator long multiplication. So with this we have completed arithmetic instruction. In the next session you will see logical instruction. Thank you.